IPI process and why companies go public in general.
An IPO is an initial public offering. It's the first time a stock is offered for sale to the general population.
Now, the reason they do this is because they want to raise capital. But like most companies, they usually start out from humble beginnings and they're usually small. But as time goes on, they usually get bigger and then they require a lot more capital to operate and get to that next step, which is to become a big corporation. Part of becoming that big corporation is issuing shares into the public. So when a company first issues shares to the public, this is called the initial public offering. So when a company first issues shares into the public, they're giving up ownership or equity in return for money. You will have management operate the companies like the CEOs and the board of executives, but the ownership is with the stockholders, everyday regular people. This is essentially the very basic fundamental reason why companies go public. They need money to operate and get bigger. That's essentially it. And it often depends on the characteristic of the business. So for example, banks and airline companies are notoriously known for always being public because these are referred to as capital-intensive businesses, meaning they require a lot of capital. Where do they get that capital? Well, it's best to go into the public. Why is it best to do this? Because it's free. When you go to the bank, you have to pay off debt. Where else are you going to get this money? You give equity into your company. You have no obligation to pay them back. It's a risk the shareholder is making. They're going to ride the successes with you in the company, and they may be subject to the fall and the failures with you. Now, the process of becoming public is actually very simple to comprehend if you look at it from a broad perspective. You have a company, and they are looking to go public. At the time they are going public, they probably just have a few owners. However, when they're done with this process, they probably have millions. So the company does two things first. One, they go to the SEC to get authorization. And the SEC goes over the company and they authorize how many shares they can issue. This is called the authorized shares. And then they often go to one of the big investment banks. And this is what investment banks primarily specialize in. They hire the investment bank to go over all these complex financial metrics by these highly trained business professionals. And once they derive all these formulas, the investment bank decides how many shares to issue and at what price. And investment banks are usually compensated on a commission basis. The company wants to ensure that the IPO process is successful. And it's up to the investment bank to make sure that happens. So the company only paid depending on how successful this is. There are times throughout history where an investment bank has essentially become a failure in trying to IPO a company. What would be a failure in the IPO process? It'd be when they try to issue shares, nobody buys them, and therefore they don't raise the capital that they need. So when the investment bank does attract heat in the market to buy these shares, they first go through what's called the primary market. The primary market is made up of a few big institutions and key financial players that are essentially just first in line to buy up these shares. Once they exit the primary market, they enter what's called the secondary market. Now, the secondary market is the market you are familiar with. This is the market that's reported on the news. This is the market that has a lot of participants and goes through the daily and minute-to-minute fluctuations. The participants in the market are institutional and retail investors, whereas in the primary market, they're mostly just authorized institutional investors. And what you have to understand is once they're in the secondary market, where the share price goes doesn't actually affect the capital raised by the company. They make their money in the primary market. Once it enters the secondary market, what happens to the share price actually doesn't affect the performance of the company. And then it becomes a reverse process. The performance of the company actually affects